Hello everybody and welcome back to the Chassis Variant Series of myself, Critical Rocket, and here we are with the Adders, also known as the Pumas within the Inner Sphere. The Adder C is one of the original variants of the Adder that was in Technical Readout 3050, and its omission is, I guess, understandable. It wasn't added originally in MWO, it's yet to be added officially. It's a pretty simple, straightforward build, a couple of LRM-15s, one in each arm, a medium pulse laser in the left torso, I believe, and a NARC launcher in the right torso. Or, it's the switch around, the medium pulse in the right and the NARCs in the left, I can't quite remember. Essentially, it turns the Adder into a long-range fire support platform. It's got more than enough ammunition, and obviously it's relatively heat-neutral. Of course, for any kind of short-range combat, it's deeply, deeply unsuited, and thus it needs to run with a fast lance that can help protect it and, you know, make sure it can keep enemies away, while it itself does a fair amount of damage with its two LRM-15s. Actually quite enjoy it, but as I said earlier, I think I can understand why this particular version wasn't kept within MWO from the start. There's already enough base clan mechs from the original pack that could do the LRM role. You already had, I think there was a version of the Kit Fox by default that came with a bunch of LRMs, you had some of the medium mechs that did it, like the Stormcrow for instance, and going up into the heavies and the assaults, it was more than easy enough to make LRM builds. And the main selling point of the Adder originally was the fact that it was a 35-tonner that could bring two ERPPCs to the field and give you enough to mess around with energy weapons instead, whereas the Kit Fox was a bit more ballistic missile mixed. However, I do quite like this version. Although the base speed of the Adder is only 97 kph, obviously up to a little over 100 with the benefit of speed tweak, which this doesn't have. I bought a fresh Adder Prime and used the Omnipods to construct it that way. It's surprisingly good. The NARC beacon does work quite well in its favour, especially in maps such as you see here with Tourmaline, allowing it to basically force enemies away from you. NARC beacons are very good at that. Even just the threat that other mechs can start hitting you with missiles is enough to make players back off and head into cover, which means in that instance there, that cataphract that was firing at me didn't want to stick around very long just in case other mechs got into position. Oh, there we go, sorry about that. Just in case other mechs got into position and started beating the crap out of him with missile fire. So it's a kind of semi-deterrent, as well as being a means for you to really pile on the pressure. Yeah, obviously the drawbacks are all the usual things with the Adder, the low slung arms syndrome, and the fact that probably ammunition could be better. An LRM dedicated mech in MWO does need a lot of ammunition to make it, you know, run particularly efficiently for many players, as they want the ability to just constantly drop missiles after missile after missile. As a base variant, I don't mind it, actually. I would actually like to see this in the game, if PGI ever did decide to go back and add missing variants. I think it's an unfortunate one to miss out. Especially since it's quite fun to have that support fire option, as I know a lot of players like that role, and having to build it yourself out of, you know, sort of Frankenstein Omnipods is kind of crap. But still, it's at least you could build it. Within the lore sort of background, well, the Adder is obviously a mech used by Clan Star Adder. It was primarily built by them, although the Adder, by the time of the invasion, was already within numerous Clan Taumans, as its capabilities were more than obvious to the rest of the clans when they saw, as I said, a light mech that carried such a powerful complement in its prime form and had lots of opportunities to be built into different configurations that could make it rather effective. As such, it was used by nearly all of the invading clans, and Clan Star Adder were, even though they were the sort of the progenitors and the main users of it, it became popular with Jade Falcon, Wolf, Ghost Bear, and even the Smoke Jaguars, and had quite a illustrious history with all four clans and all the clans since. I can't remember if its production ends up being stymied by the War of Reaving. I can't remember if the home clans lose the ability to make any more adders. They wanted to kind of make it so certain clan mechs became rarer and they had to build new ones, kind of thing. And some of the invading ones, I think the Warhawk is an example as well, or the Masakari. That's another one that by the later period, in the sort of late 3060s, early 3070s, some of these invading clan machines are progressively a bit like the Innisphere in 3025. They become less and less and less common. To the point where they may go extinct. Each one lost is irreplaceable. I think that may have happened to the adder in the future, but I'm not 100% sure. Still though, it's a lot of fun. I liked running it. Hope you all enjoyed watching it and hearing me ramble over incoherently as I usually do. This was the first clan mech video of 2019. I'm glad it was the adder. It's always been one of the ones I enjoy in the clan lineup. So yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you have a good week, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye!